Good evening, everyone. So before I start my actual presentation, let me take a blessing from all my teachers on this auspicious day of Guru Purnima. I would sincerely thank Telangana Homeopathic Medical Association for inviting me to share my experiences on COVID-19 homeopathic management. So what is this COVID-19? It is called as a novel coronavirus. So when you hear this word novel, that indicates that we are not fully aware of this disease. That means there is always a chance that the disease will go on modifying, and there is a large amount of medical aspect which we are not sure. But what we are sure is of homeopathic principle. The fundamentals of the homeopathic principles, which allowed us to take a challenge of treating any illnesses if we are following the direction of our great master, Dr. Samuel Kahneman. What I would be sharing with you is some of the experiences. To begin with, I will share two cases of the same family members, which allows us to understand the concept of individualization. Yes, concept of individualization even in COVID-19 cases. Then there is one case which tells us the uncertainty of the disease and how suddenly from a mild form the case gets transferred into severe category. We have been treating cases as an adjuvant therapy in various hospitals. I'll be sharing one case where the homeopathy is added on the existing treatment. So that will allow us to understand what is the exact scope of homeopathy even in cases where the homeopathy is done add-on. As the COVID-19 cases are increasing, there would be a lot of impact on the psych or the mental plane. And we'll come across a lot of cases where there is an effect on mental plane. So at the end, I would like to share one case where there is a major impact on the mental plane. Now, this is the first case, the initial one of the case which we have treated. Now, the case started, the person started is a 42-year man who started weakness and 100-degree temperature. There was a throat irritation and he was constantly drinking warm water. So obviously at that time, it was not very sure that each case will be of a COVID. So the local doctor started antibiotic and he advised you can come after 2 or 3 days. So on the third day, when the patient goes, there was no change. On suspecting possibility of COVID, the local doctor added one more antibiotics and advised certain tests like CBC, CRP, and COVID-19. After taking 3 days more treatment, the weakness further increased and the report also came, was COVID positive. Now, important investigations are CBC, especially WBC count, where you will see the relatively lower side of a WBC count, which indicates there is a viral infection, and especially in COVID, that is more. CRP is another indicator where it indicates the inflammatory stage of the disease, and it will also guide us to understand the severity of the cases. Knowing that now antibiotic may not have any further role, the doctor also advised to stop antibiotic and he added vitamin C and B12. But the temperature was still continuing. So he was asked to take a homeopathic treatment. So we started homeopathic treatment with this symptomatology. Yes, there is a weakness which is increasing. The fever, there is a spelling mistake in that. It is 100 to 101.4 degree Fahrenheit. Throat pain, which is better by warm. And one more observation which family member reported, that there is a weakness, but the patient is very restless. He constantly trying to get out of the bed. So with this understanding, we formulated the totality. And the totality, now it is very interesting to understand how to formulate a totality. Because in most of the COVID cases, you will see there are only set of the symptoms which will come more repeated. And majority of the patient will report with that. So in this case, what we realize that weakness is the first important symptom with the intensity. Then weakness with restlessness, thirst increased for warm water, and a local modality which is better by warm. So principle used in formation of the totality was the concept of evolution. That is, which symptom came first and how the disease evolved, along with concept of concomitant, that is a behavioral symptom, general symptom, and local modality. So with this, we after repertorization, we came to a conclusion that it is a remedy arsenic is coming up, and we prescribe arsenic album 203 times in a day. So on the second day, immediately, the first change what we notice that the patient slept very peacefully. So that means the restlessness which the family members were complaining that has completely gone. There was a reduction in the weakness. The temperature has definitely come down. It is around 99 degrees Fahrenheit. And appetite has improved. The throat pain also improved around 40%. However, there is a lot of anxiety about family. Naturally, when you are having a COVID positive, the anxiety symptom comes. He was maintaining SpO2 around 96. And we continued arsenic album 203 times in a day. After 3 days of a treatment, the person was better on the third day. The weakness much, much better. He could do daily work, no fever, throat pain also was better. So we ordered the repeat investigation to understand what is happening. And when the next day the report came, the COVID test was negative. The CRP has reduced. That means the inflammatory marker has reduced. The WBC also shows slight increase. That means the immunity of the person is definitely increased. We continued arsenic album 2 times for a couple of days, and the treatment was stopped. So there was first important thing, the improvement was in the general symptom, followed by in local symptom. Around the same time, when the wife who was staying in the same apartment, though patient was isolated in one room, but on the fourth day of her husband's illness, she also started with fever. Her fever was little on the higher side and the weakness was comparatively less. But she complained of a lot of body pain, neck pain, and headache, along with dry cough. There was no test and no thirst. Though as advised by everyone, she was forcibly drinking warm water. So immediately investigations were advised. The doctor on the safer side, local doctor, prescribed antibiotics. However, after 2 days when the report came, the report was positive. And again, now interesting thing, her CRP level was 12. That means definitely there is more inflammatory activity. On the same day, the husband report came positive. And there was a tremendous anxiety and the effect of anxiety that she started to lose motion. There was an increased prostration and body ache. So on this, considering this, we formulated the totality. And the totality was anticipatory anxiety leading to loose motion, prostration, thirstlessness, which is very characteristic because with 102 fever also she was not having thirst, with headache and body ache. So the principle used again, the concomitant mental expressions and its somatic effect, the general symptom with the intensity, and local modalities also was considered. Considering that, the gelsemium 200 was prescribed. Now you can understand, though they are staying in the same house, so that means the strain of virus is the same, still both have been presenting with a different presentation. And that's the individuality we had to identify in each case. Now what happened further? On the second day, immediate impact on her anxiety. The anxiety reduced, the fever rate came down around 99, and the prostration also improved. She did not pass any stool, body ache and other pain also has reduced. So we continued gelsemium 3 times in a day. And on the fifth day, that is of the treatment, the anxiety was completely gone, the body ache was gone. We repeated investigation. By that time, the COVID test was not repeated. As per the government law, it was not mandatory. But the inflammatory activity has reduced. So we had given our placebo, and obviously there was a need of constitutional treatment. So what we have realized, if the susceptibility is in a good state, because the patient through a lot of characteristics, then the result is also faster. So in a way, what we learn through this experience is that the most important thing is the individualization. So we treated around 8 to 10 cases, all were home quarantine, milder variety. But in forming the totality, the concept of evolution and concomitant was used very consciously. Obviously, that increased our confidence to treat. That means we can also treat COVID-19 cases. There was a case in our building. Our neighbor son was positive and he was admitted. And the father, who was 66 years old, he started weakness. So son was admitted, so there was no question of treating. But we started, the family consulted for the treatment of father. He complained of fever and a weakness. So what was the presentation? The son was admitted, so there was a weakness, no desire to eat, and the fever was 100. So they initially consulted another family, their family physician. He just advised, you take Dolo 650 and possibly the settings will settle down. After 2 days of treatment, the weakness did not reduce. So we ordered investigation. And they said, we should start homeopathy as well. Now, there were hardly any characteristics. The only presenting symptom was weakness. And possibly he is worried about son. So the anxiety also, though he did not mention that, but the anxiety was symptoms. So these were the only two symptoms, plus our previous experience. On that, we started arsenic album 200 QDS. After 2 days, we saw the weakness was same. That means the remedy has not registered, because our experience was at least there should be some change within 24 hours of the treatment and in a general symptom. So that did not happen. Now, this patient was not talking to us directly, and the family members were giving information. So it was very difficult, very challenging to understand the individual. So the worry was, son was there, lot of anxiety was there, anticipation, what will happen. So on further inquiry, when we asked why he's not eating, and then they said he is not eating any sweets, he was very fond of that. And we got our characteristics. So aversion to sweet, even though the person was having a craving with anxiety and a weakness, we prescribe argentum natricum 200 QDS. Now immediately we saw there was a change in the appetite. That means most likely the remedy has registered. However, the weakness did not add any impact. Now he was lying full day in a bed, but he had shira, that means the sweet thing, milk, fruit juice. So some change was there. Report was awaited, but he was maintaining SpO2 around 96 and 97. So we continued for one more day. The next day, again, the weakness was same. That means we are missing something, because after 48 hours also, if there is no change in the general symptoms, that means we have missed something. So we wanted to speak with the patient and he was not ready. So there was a depressed mood and there was a blood pressure. There was a rise in the blood pressure. Now, fortunately, the COVID test came negative. Now, a very interesting thing that have happened. He has been tested twice. Government BMC people came and then tested. And where he was working, the company also sent to for a private lab for a testing. So he was tested twice. The private lab report came very early and it was negative. So we advised, considering his slightly depressed mood and weakness not changing, or a bed. After 3 days, since COVID was negative, we were also a little relaxed and we could found weakness has reduced. He can do at least daily activity, but this mood was not changing and the blood pressure was on the slightly higher side. So we advised that we should continue Aurumet for some time, but a family member felt, since it is not COVID and the blood pressure is increasing, so let consult physician for his depression or depressed mood. So they decided and they had taken opinion. So we also felt, okay, it's little better. And the weakness reduced. Now, he has not taken any Aurumet they stop. So the physician evaluated and he said he needs a mild antidepressant. So that's mainly because of the worry of the son, and apart from there is nothing. Now our experience was, when we were seeing this patient on 29 May, that is the 18th day of the treatment, now, most of the time the patient is better for first 10 days, then most likely he's going to be improving. Now that was related to COVID-19. Now on the 18th day, surprisingly, after so many days, the government report came. Unfortunately, it got delayed due to a lot of technical things, but the test was positive. And the same day, patient started sudden breathlessness. The blood pressure went up 200 and 110, and then we inquired, he has not slept for last 6 days. Since considering the severity of the illness, he was advised to hospitalize. There was a lot of struggle they have to undergo to get a bed. Finally, after 6 hours of struggle, they could get a bed at 8 p.m. Immediately the test report came. Within a couple of hours, the CRP has shot up to 32. The LDH was very high, IL-6 also very high, and TOPP also positive. That means after a long phase of quietism, was one of the things, he was not being given any treatment, but the disease took a long time to come to. That means the underlying activity was going on, even though there was no presentation. Unfortunately, the next day, early morning, around 5 o'clock, the patient passed away. And that has created a lot of chaos in the family and in the mind of homeopaths. What has had actually happened? That means the symptoms may not be the every time guide. So we must do actively clinico-pathological correlation and do investigation to understand what is the state of the patient. Cytokines are strong. That is one of the possibility. The suddenly things was quieter, and then suddenly everything come. Issue of false negative and false positive test may be there in this case, and it may come future. So that means we need to be very alert. So each case, even there is a success or failure, gives a lot of learning. Now I'm sharing one of the case. Now I'm sharing this case because this is a case of father of my compounder. Somebody has told me, like, we hear a lot of numbers, like this many cases became positive, this many cases became death. So all this statistic doesn't have any much relevance unless until you experience a tragedy. And tragedy means something happening to your near and dear one. So this Mr. SG, 49 year, developed sudden weakness, throat irritation. There was a pricking type of pain. And the fever started around midnight. So I practice where it's a joint clinic where the physician is also present. So with consultation, he said we will start antibiotic and HCQ on the safer side. And the next day, since the complaint, he started complaining of chest pain, we thought it's better to get admitted. There was a lot of cough and profuse expectoration. So from mild to moderate, he traveled very fast. Investigations, we found HB is low, CRP again 32, WBC count going down, HGPT increase, and also X-ray. Now X-ray was well-defined opacity on both lower zones. Right side was much larger than the left. It was a signs of congestion. That means already the pneumonia is setting up. So he was having a breathlessness, so he was put on oxygen. Now SpO2 was maintaining only after 6 liters of oxygen. Now you understand the severity of the case. So the rapidly how he's progressing. Now what happened subsequently? So on the 3rd June, the complaint started increasing. The fever was not settling. The pain started more. The breathlessness was more, and the consultant said, can we add something from homeopathy? because since we were working together here, he knew some of our experiences, and he felt since he is maintaining O2 only at 9 liters of oxygen level, it's better that something should be added. And then COVID test also was positive by that time. He was put on another antibiotics. So since we were having some experience of managing cases, we started, we will add homeopathy. And then we started homeopathy with the following totality. Now, what was the totality on that case? So here we have taken the Boger's approach, because there was a lot of pathological generals were there. The pneumonia, more on the right side than the left side. The weakness, again, the concept of evolution. The first symptom, the chest pain, which was lying on a pain. The pneumonia was on, more on the right side. And again, he was getting aggravation by lying on the right side. Cough, getting aggravated at night, and typical pricking pain and his anxious state. So Boger's approach fits in. If you refer Borland pneumonia, a lot of details has been given. So we use that principle. Now, since there was a more sensitivity because of the pain and anxiety, at the same time structural changes, and we wanted to repeat medication more frequently, so we opted for LN potency. So Calicap 0x1, 4 hourly was started. On the second day, again, you will observe the weakness immediately reduced. There was a change. Obviously, the cough has increased because the pathology has gone into a different stage. The pneumonia has gone into different stage. So there is a lot of expectoration is expected. Breathlessness was still same. The anxiety was still same. But fever. Now, obviously, he was on antipyretic. So we continued 4 hourly. Additional antibiotic was stopped. So we wanted to continue one more day. There was slight change in the weakness. The breathlessness definitely has gone down. The throat pain has gone down. That means the medicine has registered. Now he is maintaining now SpO2 at 6 liter. So we wanted to have more little aggressive, because we need to be one step ahead of the disease so that we can manage it well. So we shifted the potency to 0x2, 4 hours. The antipyretic was given only at night. The next day again, he was much better. He could sit down in a bed for a longer time. Cough was increased, but we were not bothered of cough at that time because the breathlessness has gone down. And he was maintaining SpO2 without oxygen. That was a definite change in the patient. So we continued again Calicap 4 hourly, 0x2. And for the next 7 days, we continued 4 hourly, and there was a gradual improvement. The CRP level has gone down. In such cases, we have seen that we need to continue medicine for a longer time, because our previous experience also was stating that way. So homeopathy, though it was add-on, it has a definite role. What was important is the communication with the consultant, the teamwork. Accurate assessment of the susceptibility is more important. And how to formulate totality is based on the indication and the stage of the disease. Peculiar symptom always help to differentiate closely coming up remedies. And the posology, we need to give it more frequently and a repeated dose. And remember to continue medicine till the recovery. Otherwise, as normally, if the improvement starts, we stop the medicine. Plus, please don't do in COVID cases, because the underlying pathology may continue. Now, this is the last case which I would like to present, because some of you will get this kind of a presentation. Now, she is a 29-year female police constable. On 38, she developed a headache with intermittent type of headache, pulling type of sensation, mild throat irritation, and little weakness. Since she was in a government frontline worker, the test was again immediately done, and it kept positive. Though she did not have many much more symptoms, she was kept in a government quarantine center. We collected the data. Dr. Devangini Broker, she's helping me in collecting the data. So she collected the detail on the 2nd June, and we started the treatment. The current state was, there was hardly any throat irritation. So there was hardly any specific indication of any remedy. Mild symptom, But what was characteristic was her vexation state. Now she was given in a police duty in a prisoner's, managed the prisoner in a very unhygienic condition. She requested her superior to change the duty, but then they said, and also she was allergic to dust, but they forced her duty. She did it. She did it very positively. Unfortunately, one of the prisoner who was having the fever tested positive, and her state of vexation came up. The vexation was entire system, and there was also anxiety about her child was small. He was at home. We further inquire into life space, and then similar pattern. She was extremely sensitive to reprimand, irritable nature, and a tendency to become vexatious. And on that totality, we've decided staphylococcus aureus is her constitutional remedy with vexation state, sensitivity, anxiety, and further characteristics. So the current picture, the predominant was a mental state. Now you will get lot of many patient predominant mental state, and that's a key of managing such cases. Now somebody will go into anxiety state, somebody will go into anger, irritability, and vexation. Somebody will become different, indifferent, and that will give key to which kind of remedies are indicated. If there are less expressions, so there is hardly any role of acute remedy, and we need to prescribe constitutional medicine. So she was given staphylococcus aureus 200 daily. There was an immediate change. She was relaxed. Her state has changed. Headache and other symptoms went away immediately. Though medicine was continued, she was discharged and went home. After 10 days, when we took a follow-up, there was slight breathlessness, but she was maintaining SpO2. Of course, by going home, she was neglected by the society because she was COVID positive, tested positive. She wept for 2-3 days, and she developed again hypersensitivity. Now we have seen in lot many cases post COVID, the patients are developing some kind of a hypersensitivity. Again, you have to manage based on indication, considering a state of weepiness and a cough. Pulsatilla was given, and then she settled down. She improved. She started laughing, and again going become normal. So whatever cases we have collectively treated, around 50-60 cases, we have found these remedies are more frequently coming up. In the initial days, bryonia was coming up more frequently, then arsenic, phosphorus, gelsemium, calica, pulsatilla, lycopodium, and timtart. Nowadays, rustox is also coming up. And what helped us is our master's experience, the concept of Boger, Kent, and concept of complete symptom that really help in managing the cases. So what we have learned in through cases, as far as the disease is concerned, COVID-19 is still novel. That means there is a diverse presentation and may have erratic behavior. Timely doing appropriate investigation and clinical pathological correlation is must. Mild cases after silent phase may go to a rapid phase. You need to be more alert. And accurate assessment of susceptibility is a key of managing the disease. In terms of totality formation, how to formulate totality? Complete symptom, LSMC. If there are characteristic, prescribe acute remedy. In that also, concomitant mental and physical state has the highest importance. So pay attention to that, because sensation-wise, you will get more common presentation. If you are getting LSMC, mild to moderate case, if there are no much concomitant, then focus on the evolution of the symptom, which symptom came first, and you can prescribe acute remedy. If there are mild symptoms, then maybe deeper acting or a constitutional approach is needed. In terms of posology, susceptibility is a true guide to decide the posology. 30 and 200 cases potency we have prescribed in most of the cases. And LM potency, wherever we have found high sensitivity and a lot of structural changes. Repetition in most of the cases required, frequent repetition, and treatment has to be continued even after 7 to 8 days after last appearance of the symptom. This is very important. Don't stop remedy till you get absolute clarity for 7 to 8 days. I would like to thank all my patients who have trusted homeopathy government officials who had given us opportunity to treat cases, our MLD MHI faculty, my colleague Dr. Devangani, who took the history and gave opportunity to treat those cases, Homeopathic Medical Association of Telangana to allow me to share my experience, and your time and for sparing on Sunday. This is my contact detail. If you have any queries, you can contact. Thank you. Thank you very much. Recording.